Russia's invasion of Ukraine has led to a sense of panic around the world, with many harboring memories of the Soviet Union's Tsar Bomba and the impact this had back on October 30, 1961. The thermonuclear bomb was dropped over Novaya-Zemlya Island, deep in the Arctic Ocean, in the most extreme northeastern part of Europe. The Tsar Bomba is the most powerful thermonuclear weapon ever detonated, as no other bomb as strong has ever been tested. While there were no deaths from the Tsar Bomba's test, there were windows shattered due to the explosion 700 Etikum, 480 miles away in a village on Dixon Island. However, in the aftermath of the Cuban Missile Crisis, then U.S. President John F. Kennedy managed to convince the Soviet Union to limit nuclear testing to underground sites. Then, on October 7, 1963, the United States, the United Kingdom, and the Soviet Union signed the Partial Nuclear Test Ban Treaty, which forbade tests in the atmosphere, outer space, and underwater. As such, with the signing of this treaty, these countries ensured that no one would detonate a Tsar Bomba-style weapon ever again. What is the Tsar Bomba? Tsar Bomba is the Western nickname for the Soviet RDS-220 hydrogen bomb, detonated by the Soviet Union on October 30, 1961. Tsar Bomba is the largest nuclear device ever detonated and the most powerful man-made explosion in history. With a yield of 50 megatons of TNT, Tsar Bomba was the culmination of a number of hydrogen bomb tests conducted throughout this time by both the Soviet Union and the United States. The Tsar Bomba was a three-stage hydrogen bomb with a Tretyakov second and third stage design. A three-stage hydrogen bomb uses a fission-type atomic bomb as the first stage to compress the thermonuclear second stage. The energy produced from this explosion is then directed to compress the much larger thermonuclear third stage. There is evidence that Tsar Bomba utilized several third stages. Tsar Bomba could have theoretically yielded as much as 100 megatons, but it would have resulted in a dangerous level of nuclear fallout. Approximately 25% of all fallout produced since the invention of nuclear weapons in 1945. Additionally, the delivery plane would not have had sufficient time to retreat to a safe distance, therefore, to minimize nuclear fallout. The third stage incorporated a lead tamper instead of a uranium-238 fusion tamper. It has been speculated that the second stage used this method as well. The uranium-238 fusion tamper greatly amplifies the reaction by fissioning uranium atoms with fast neutrons from the fusion reaction. Because fast fissioning was eliminated, thermonuclear fusion accounted for as much as 97% of the yield. Thus, despite its huge yield, Tsar Bomba did not actually generate much nuclear fallout. The goal of the Tsar Bomba project. In the mid-1950s, the United States had an unconditional superiority over the USSR in nuclear weapons, although thermonuclear charges had already been created in the USSR at this time. Also, there were no effective means of delivering nuclear warheads to the US, both in the 1950s and in 1961. The USSR was not therefore able to muster a possible realistic retaliatory nuclear strike against the US. Given the Soviet Union's actual strategic disadvantage in relation to America's nuclear weapons possessions, foreign policy and propaganda considerations during the leaderships of Georgi Malenkov and Nikita Khrushchev made a response to the perceived U.S. nuclear blackmail imperative. The creation of the Tsar Bomba represented a necessitated bluff in order to maintain the concept of nuclear deterrence. Also on June 23, 1960, the resolution of the Council of Ministers of the USSR was issued on the creation of a super-heavy ballistic missile N1, with a warhead weighing 75 tons, for a comparative assessment. The weight of the warhead tested in 1964 by the UR-500 Eichbaum was 14 tons. The development of new designs of nuclear and thermonuclear ammunition requires testing. The operability of the device, its safety in emergency situations, and the calculated energy release during an explosion must be confirmed. Tsar Bomba transport plane. A Tu-95V Soviet long-range bomber piloted by Major Andrei Durnovstev delivered Tsar Bomba during the test. The bomber was accompanied by a Tu-16 observer plane that was responsible for collecting air samples and filming the test. A reflective white paint was used on the planes to minimize thermal damage to their surfaces. Tsar Bomba weighed 27 metric tons, or 59,525 pounds. It was 26 feet in length and 6.9 feet in diameter. The bomb bay doors and fuselage fuel tanks were removed from the Tu-95V due to its large size. Tsar Bomba was attached to a parachute weighing nearly 1,800 pounds, which provided the bomber and observer planes additional time to fly approximately 30 miles away from ground zero prior to detonation. Despite the addition of reflective paint and the parachute, a 50/50 chance of survival was predicted for those on board. On October 30, 1961, Tsar Bomba was detonated in the atmosphere at 11:32 Moscow time over the Michushika Bay nuclear testing range in the northern Arctic Circle. The bomb was set by barometric sensors to detonate at 13,000 feet and was dropped from a height of 34,000 feet. The Tsar Bomba yield was approximately 1,570 times more powerful than the yield of the bombs dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki combined, and 10 times more powerful than all of the conventional weapons exploded during World War Roman II. Tsar Bomba also represented 25% of the estimated yield of the Krakatoa volcanic eruption of 1883, and 10% of all nuclear tests by this point. By comparison, the B-41, the largest United States nuclear weapon, had a theoretical yield of 25 megatons. The largest nuclear device ever detonated by the United States was Castle Bravo with a yield of 15 megatons. The largest nuclear weapon deployed by the Soviet Union, the SS-18 Mod 3 Eichbaum warhead, was also approximately 25 megatons. Tsar Bomba trial results. All of the wooden and brick buildings in nearby Severny, located 34 miles from the aiming point or ground zero, were annihilated. In other Soviet districts located over 100 miles from ground zero, wooden houses were demolished and brick and stone ones suffered damages. Radio communication outages were also reported. One test witness felt the thermal effects at a distance of 170 miles, even with dark goggles. The intense heat from the detonation was capable of causing third-degree burns at a distance of 62 miles from ground zero. The shock wave was felt as far away as the Dixon settlement located 430 miles away, and windows shattered at a distance of 560 miles. Windows even shattered as far away as Norway and Finland due to atmospheric focusing of the shock wave. Despite being an airburst detonated 13,000 feet above ground, Tsar Bomba's seismic magnitude was estimated at 5.25. Seismic sensors continued to register shockwaves even after a third revolution around the Earth. The original Atomic Energy Commission estimate of the Tsar Bomba yield was 55.60 megatons, but since the end of the Cold War and fall of the Soviet Union, all Russian sources have confirmed its yield as 50 megatons. Even though calculations suggested the explosion would reach the ground, this was prevented when the bomb's extremely large shockwave was reflected. The fireball nearly reached the altitude of the release aircraft. At the point of detonation, the aircraft dropped approximately 1/2 mile in altitude due to the shockwave, but would make it to safety. The Tsar Bomba mushroom cloud was approximately 40 miles high, 7 times higher than Mount Everest. The cloud reached higher than the stratosphere at its highest altitude. The top of the cloud had a width of 59 miles and the base a width of 25 miles. The extreme damage and devastation wrought by thermonuclear weapons like the Tsar Bomba is unimaginable. If such a weapon exploded in a large American city such as New York, Chicago, San Francisco, or Washington, D.C., their metropolitan areas plus large portions of their surrounding suburbs would be completely destroyed and nearly devoid of all life.